Good morning, everyone. Thank you for inviting me to be here. Because chica in Asia is like something mysterious, because the many countries not provide information to the world. Because in the first time during the Latin epidemic, they fear to be consequence of the travels on tourism, so they not want to provide the information correctly. But except Thailand, we are really aggressively determine what we are about the Chica virus. Look at the Chica virus in 1947 to 2007, before the Yap Island outbreak. If you see the Latin America is clear zone of the Chica virus, and Africa and Southeast Asia, they have report of the Chica infection sporadically. So I think we are have Chica virus in our country, but we cannot detect because of the virus. This virus is look similar to dengue. So when the Latin America they have problem, so we start implement the surveillance nationwide, universal health for surveillance. In Thailand, we have 6 flavivirus in Thailand, JE, Dengue 1-4, and Chica virus. The problem is the false positive of the serology for the clinician use is will be caution. So we determine the Dengue and Chica itself, it needs molecular technique for confirmation. For in our result is based on only molecular confirmation. We not use the serology for detection, that's all. For the vector in Thailand, we have Aegypti, Abopictus, and Culex. We also found the virus in the saliva gland of the in the Culex. We are ongoing to more research about this, and Chulalongkorn University Professor Pades is already deal with the Culex queen. And we also found tan ovarian of the Chica virus in both vector, ED Aegypti and Culex. Yeah. And during the outbreak, we also found the positive rate of the Chica virus during the outbreak in April to September 2016, approximately 7-10%. That is a proportion of positive rate of the we collect and test the Chica. I think it's so high because of the we test all adults and larva mosquito. For the non-vector borne transmission, we have or multiple loser infection. But in Thailand, we cannot confirm sexual transmitted disease because we cannot guarantee the partner will infect the mosquito, because we have plenty of mosquito infect by Chica. So we cannot confirm the sexual intercourse as a transmission route. And detection in different sample, yes, we try to get this for test the PCR and also successful for confirm the Chica in this different sample. Compared to the, we have one case, have the saliva, plasma, and urine in acute illness. They just five days after onset, and you can see urine and saliva and plasma also positive for confirmation. So now today we also use the saliva in children, for they cannot take a blood sample easily, so we collect the saliva for test PCR for that group. Even the acute case, they have also positive for urine or saliva. The first recognized Chica in Thailand, we found we got notification from Canadian health authority about the import case of the Chica case from Thailand, and okay we retrospective investigation of the unknown virus in 2012, and we also found that is a confirmed Chica virus 1 year ago, and we also prospective investigation in outbreak of rash from 13 to 15. This is before Latin America outbreak. We do is because at that time no one care about the Chica in country, but we have surveillance by the outbreak investigation. This is the Canadian infect in Thailand. Yeah, and the second case is from German traveler infect in Thailand and confirmed in German. And the third case is Japan go to Samui and they have a rash and then they are confirmed in urine. And the fourth case is from Taiwan, the Thai export to Taiwan, and we have a lot of export case of Chica in the country. This is really very uncommon in Thailand that we export the case to other country. This is archive sample of a 13 sample that at that time we think this case this event is out is a dengue outbreak, because if you see the ELISA of dengue or ELISA of IgG, they are so positive, but we not when we send to USCDC, they are also positive for IgM, and we also PINT also positive for T case. Other can determine, cannot determine the Chica virus. Only three cases that we found at that time. So this case is not dengue, but it's a Chica. This is the characteristic of the dengue that we undetermined and we classify as a dengue fever outbreak in the country, and then they turn to be Chica. And this is the last MPS of the case. It's a very 100% of the case and less I of the case and so on. This is a surveillance of the from 12 to 14. We test in only blood, so the case is very low number. I published in the American Journal about the 7 cases. This published before the Latin America outbreak. So this is a very good one that we have Chica before 2015. Okay, and this is subproductive case from 12 to 15. This based on only PCR. So this is a nationwide of the confirmed case in all regions. And molecular sequencing of the case in Thailand is close with fenfluramine strain. And for the whole genome sequencing in Thailand, we have done for 10 sample. This one is lower one is a strain from the Southeast Asia mostly. Southeast Asia, the blue one is we not just submit in the gene bank, but you see in another 5 in Thailand, we also in the really cluster of the Chica virus. Compared to this one is from Latin America. It's really very different from our country. So in 2016, we developed the national surveillance nationwide to now. We have a case definition for three case definition is Chica fever, congenital Chica syndrome in newborn, Guillain-Barré syndrome. This is the main three category of the surveillance data. And lab capacity, of course, and good luck that we confirmed the Chica before 2015. So in 2014, we got assist by the USCDC to lab building capacity in Thailand. So we have a 14 regional lab center can test the PCR. That's why there are not a problem to in Thailand for the hospital to submit the sample to test the Chica. So the information, this information is favor us to confirm the Chica. And for the care division, we adapt from the Yap Island because they have a prototype of our country. So we have a complex care division from pregnancy, general In adults and pediatric, congenital Chikungunya syndrome and Guillain-Barré is a very comprehensive and different. Attention, Chika virus in Thailand is notified by law. If you're not, there are cover or private and public hospital to do report 7 days after detection. If they cannot to do so, the penalty of €500 per case will be applied. So what we support them to do this, because as you see, the penalty and required is very high. So all lab costs, PCR is free of charge. So the hospital no need to pay, or the case no need to pay the lab cost. So the lab cost is respond for MOPS. And total budget PCR cost in only 2016, 1 year, is $2 million a year. That's very high investment, because we not use serology for testing. That's why I can say it's complicated in the low income country that it use a molecular technique. This is the care division for pregnancy. This is an adult, and this is in pediatric case, they are different, and also baby with congenital anomaly, they are different, and the last one is Guillain-Barré syndrome, three category of the Chika syndrome. Okay, and this is the result of 2 years of the surveillance. You can see in 2016, the peak of a pandemic is in the late of the season, the late of the monsoon. And 2017, there are peak in the monsoon as well. When I compare with the dengue, the peak of dengue in 2016, the peak of dengue in 2015 is week 33rd. That means the Chika is outbreak is followed by the dengue outbreak. And 2017, again, the peak of dengue of 2017 is week 23rd, that about 6 to 8 weeks after peak of the dengue. And this year, 2018, they have really the cycle of epidemic of the dengue in Thailand. Now, we face with the Chika outbreak in the early season in this year. We plan to, if someone want to research in this year in Thailand, is a really golden time for investment in this year, I think, because the number of cases at this moment is very high, both dengue and Chika. We also have asymptomatic, asymptomatic we have because our protocol, the pregnancy, if someone confirm Chika case in the sub-district, we will collect all pregnancy. Even they not have clinical presentation, we collect asymptomatic people to determine the asymptomatic in the pregnancy. This is a characteristic of the clinical presentation of Chika in Thailand. Yes, I think it's similar to the Latin America or other area. It lasts 80% and fever is 60% and red eye, joint pain and myalgias. And this is the distribution of the age group of the Chika in 2016. You see, mostly is children and adolescent and adults, and they are declined in the elderly. And the same, the morbidity rate per 100 population, yet it picture look alike the number. In 2017, it's the same. The majority is in adults and children, and morbidity is the same. Yeah. For 2 years, the distribution is the same, very perfectly met with the age group. That this picture is look like dengue in Thailand as well. This is the geographic area that we detect in 16, 17, and 18. You see, even only half year, this year will have a high burden of the disease in Chika in Thailand. And you can see, observe that the area that have positive Chika in here, they also repeated outbreak in the same area. So this is such as the dengue, Chika in Thailand is an endemic city, endemic now, it's not emerging. For totally confirmed case of the pregnancy, we have 121 case, and with symptomatic is 67 case, and 55% is symptomatic, and 44% is asymptomatic. And 108 pregnancy women delivery about 90%, and miscarriage for 4 case, and birth anomaly for 4 case. This 7.4% is similar to US CDC study that they announced about 5 to 11% of the abnormality of the pregnancy. And for microcephaly surveillance result, we found now 4 cases, but other is 3 cases confirmed by PCR or IgM. They born from the unregistered pregnancy. That this group is not belonging to. Okay. This I will mention about this birth anomaly for case is different from this case. This case is a child, not no matter, it's not no infection. Okay, they born with the abnormality, and we test the chica for them, and we found 4 case now about the congenital chica infection in Thailand. And Guillain-Barré syndrome, yes, we confirmed by PCR in both 3 cases, and 1 case died about the Guillain-Barré. This is a miscarriage in the pregnancy example. They have a plenty of the miscarriage in Thailand that caused by chica, but we not know because we not test the concept that, of this case. Because this case, no, because we collect the sample. This woman live in the confirmed case of the chica, and we collect the urine and blood for them. They got infection at least 12 weeks in the first trimester, and she miscarried on week 25 of gestational with a death fetus 1,000 gram, and lab confirmed positive on matter. And of course, in the fetus, we also collect the sample for them that caught but placenta and brain necropsy. We do the brain necropsy for the children also positive chica in this concept. That I can say this miscarriage cannot we not determine in the endemic country about the chica, because I think they have a lot, because when they miscarriage, they not investigation what cause of the miscarriage, and they have something a lot of this miscarriage. And microcephaly also, we came supply with microcephaly, and the CT brain also showed the calcification, and typically for chica infection and confirmed chica. And the child for the newborn and until on the 6 months, the child, when the child grows, the microcephaly will be appear obviously. And also we determine the burden of the chica in meso elimination program. We select we want to know about in the meso group, we want to know how many of the chica consists in the meso elimination program. We know that the rubella is 1% in the meso elimination program. So we use the archive sample. We add the archive sample from the NAS in 2016, and we have the inclusion criteria that meso and rubella should be negative, and then we collect a sample and then test for PCR for two method, US CDC method and Altona commercial method, and then sequencing. If there are only one protocol positive, we will do the sequencing. So we found one positive for both technique, one case, and we found five cases for sequencing that either any one of them are positive for single protocol. And we found the positive Chika six sample approximately 4%. So we know that the Chika also inside the measles. So we ask in Southeast country, ASEAN, that we have we has missing in Phuket. We the Southeast Asia will be explore this first because it easy to determine the Chika in this area. But the 3.9 is will be under estimation because we use PCR and the sample for measles for serum is should be convalescent, so the number I think the number of the case will be higher than this. And diagnosis of Chika based on molecular technique. So if we use the antibody, it will be increased incident, but we not rely on serology. For asymptomatic rates in Thailand, we study in we want to know the previous report in Yap Island 80% and Thailand we not know about the endemic disease. So when the in the case confirmed by two protocol, we will go to the field and collect blood and urine for all villagers who age 15 years, and then we will follow up 21 days and revisit for collection again for the same person. We about 489 enrolled in seven province entire country. 74 people were positive PCR either first time or second time, and 44 symptomatic and 30 asymptomatic. Asymptomatic rate is about 40%. This is half than Yap Island, but we cannot compare because Yap Island use antibody, but in Thailand use only molecular. So I can say the asymptomatic rate will be higher if we use the zero conversion. For in Thailand, we is under diagnosis common because we have a favivirus and high clot reactivity between dengue and Chika. Now today, only molecular allowed to confirm Chika in Thailand. And high clot, yes, because the budget to confirm the Chika is very expensive. And high technique, PCR itself is not good. We use both protocol. I mean, even commercial and US CDC protocol for confirm the cases. So I think the Chika in Thailand will be higher and higher because of the dengue fever mid-diagnosis. We had a control strategy for the Chika is very concerned than dengue. That's why I love to confirm Chika in the country because the side effect is people they aware, afraid and concerned. So they are really aggressive control the mosquito compared to the scent of the dengue outbreak. The scent of the Chika outbreak is higher. So the vector control is successfully controlled in the village in the Thailand. This example of the one epidemic curve of the Chika outbreak, you can see the last one is the confirmed by PCR. You can see the PCR not good for detection because they have a 50% they are turned negative, even though I think that should be more positive than this. Yeah. Okay, the CI is really rapidly successive control. Yeah. What emerging look like in Thailand? Look at the chikungunya in 2008 to 9. They come with a really big wave, you know, and we cannot do anything, just wait and see the chikungunya African strain. This one, in 2008, they are infected from Malaysia border, and then they creeping to upper Thailand. That is a characteristic of geographic spreading of the emerging disease. And this is a nice picture that demonstrates how they are creeping from other area to another area for infection of the chikungunya. Yeah, but the Chika is not look like emerging or vector-borne emerging. So that's why we think Chika in Thailand is a endemic disease.